I'm also going to present, you know, how can you actually program some SQL. We have been discussing SQL a lot today, but we want you to. Is
it working? Yeah, it's perfect. I just turned it out. Sorry.
Okay, so we actually want people to start using SQL. A little outline of the talk. Where first I'm going to talk a little bit about SQL, ComputeCpp, the basics of SQL codes, and how does SQL fit in the C++ landscape, and we're going to summarize that. So, my name is Peter Žužek. Second one, so here I work with Roman, and so how I started with this, I basically did for my master's, I implemented an implementation of SQL. It's not a full implementation, there are many things missing, but it's kind of okay. So that's also how Codeplay contacted me, because they were also working on their implementation of SQL. And that's how I also got the job at Codeplay, and now I'm working on the ComputeCpp team as a runtime developer. So let's get started with ComputeCpp and SQL. We've already covered what SQL is. It's a Khronos standard that builds on top of OpenCL. It's cross-platform, much like OpenCL. It allows you to program for different devices, not just NVIDIA hardware, for example. And it offers single source programming. Usually in OpenCL, you need to have a separate kernel file. So you can have a separate file, or you can include the OpenCL C kernel in a string. Here in SQL, it's all in SQL file, and it's all C++, modern C++. There are no restricted keywords, no special attributes. It's just C++. And it's also because the host and the device compiler don't need to be the same. You can use any host compiler you want, and also potentially different device compilers.
Okay.
So, PCPP is the Codeplay's implementation of the SQL specification, and we recently released the community edition, the PCPP CE. It's a beta implementation, so there may be still some bugs inside. Nothing is perfect, but it's designed to help the SQL ecosystem. You can download it now for free and start using it. It's wholly owned by Codeplay. The device compiler is based on LLVM, so that's not all Codeplay. And what we ship is the device compiler and the SQL runtime library. And you don't need any other libraries besides OpenCL. So let's get into some SQL code. I don't know if you can see this, but basically this is a whole SQL program. It's also templated, so you can use different data. That's the power of C++. And what we do, it's pretty simple actually. We include the SQL header. In this case, we're also declaring to use the namespace CL SQL. And we start by declaring a queue. That's all you need to get started to initialize the SQL. If you cannot see this in this function, we pass to this function simple vadd. We pass it three pointers that represent our data and the size of these arrays that are our data. So here we define the queue, and now we define buffers. This is similar to OpenCL buffers. A buffer represents data that's on the device. So then we submit some commands to the SQL queue. Some commands that we want the SQL queue to execute. And we had the buffers previously. Buffers define the data. And here we have the access. We request access to this data on the device. and we define what kind of access we want. We say that we want to read the first two arrays and we want to write it to the last one. And then we have a parallel for construct that is basically like a for loop, except that it executes in parallel on the device. Okay, so just, and this is the actual kernel. So there is no separate kernel file. It's everything here inside. It's C++, and it's directly sent as a command to the command queue. So when is this actually executed? This is the kernels are enqueued asynchronously, and when the queue goes out of scope, everything is synchronized and the data is transferred, and by that time it's guaranteed that it's been calculated. So what can I do with SQL? It's basically almost everything that you can do in standard C++. There are some exceptions in the kernel code. What you can do, for example, there are no exceptions. You cannot do recursion, RTTI, dynamic location, but these are all limitations of the OpenCL 1.2 specification, on which the SYCL 1.2 specification is based. SYCL 2.2 specification has already been announced, and it lifts some of these restrictions. So we have the host and the OpenCL runtime. The SYCL runtime can execute without an OpenCL platform. In OpenCL, you have different devices, but the SYCL also provides the host device, the host platform, and the host device. So if you don't, you can just, this is very handy for debugging code. If you don't have, you just ignore any OpenCL devices and you run it on the CPU, and you can debug it as any other code that you have. And when you actually have OpenCL platforms, OpenCL devices, the runtime executes on those devices, and it handles all the platforms, the context, the data movement. The only thing that you really need to create is the queue, as we've seen in the code. So what's neat about SYCL is that, for example, we have here some series of commands, and basically we have a GPU queue, we have a DSP queue, and we, for example, first submit some commands to the GPU, then on to the DSP, and then to the GPU again, and this is some of the same data. And SYCL creates the SYCL runtime can create a task graph with all the dependencies. So if you then switch the order of operations, if you want to execute, for example, if you, in this case we switch the DSP with the GPU, and the SYCL runtime automatically creates all these dependencies, so you don't have to worry about that, and it automatically synchronizes, takes care of data movement and everything. As we said, kernel submission is asynchronous, and anytime you also request data on the host, this also gets synchronized. Okay, so SYCL is designed to be tolerant to failure. There is exception handling. You can also there are also asynchronous kernel errors that are handled by a user-defined function. And the kernels can also, if the execution on a queue fails for whatever reason, it's also possible to have a fallback queue. So if that fails, it just gets executed on the fallback queue, which can usually be the host queue. So it just executes on the host without any OpenCL device. This is also what ComputeCpp implements. It can capture and re-enqueue on a different queue. All dependencies are adjusted, and it's possible to customize the level of fallback. So how does SYCL fit in the broader C++ landscape? Roman already talked about parallel SDL, so I won't spend too much time on it. It's available on GitHub. It's open source, and it integrates nicely with the SYCL codebase. At Codeplay, we also developed ViZionCpp, which is a high-level vision framework. It uses expression trees as a unified frontend for different backends. So it uses SYCL and where the SYCL backend is not available, it also uses the standard C++ and OpenAP. It aims to provide cross-platform performance portability. So performance portability in the sense that you have the same percentage of peak performance on different devices. It's designed to be easy to use and with application construction and adding custom operations. Here's some comparison. We can see the blue bar is Vision CPP Fuse, and the orange bar is OpenCV. So the performance is comparable. We do slightly better. The execution time is slightly lower, but it represents a viable alternative to OpenCV. We're also working on TensorFlow at Codeplay. TensorFlow, you probably know it. It's quite famous now. It's an open source machine learning library from Google Brain, and we are working on porting TensorFlow to SYCL. We're also collaborating with Google on this. So we're porting the computational core of TensorFlow called Eigen to SYCL. And it's basically simpler to port because of C++. C++ simplifies some of the programming in the porting. And there are less modifications needed than the existing CUDA backend. And we've already contributed to the main repository of TensorFlow. So, in conclusion, the SYCL specification is already widely available. You can get it on the Khronos website. You can get it here from our reference guides. We have a blog on our company website at coplay.com. There was a tutorial on SYCL at iWalkle. We have a SYCL implementation of the C++17 parallel STL. And there are also other implementations. There's the open source tricycle implementation, which only implements the host device, but it enables developers to get into the development to start using SYCL, similar to ComputeCpp, but we also provide the different device modes. And the ComputeCpp community edition is available to download from our website. And you can download it and start using it and start developing SYCL applications. So, SYCL, just to summarize, SYCL is focused on algorithm design. It abstracts the low-level details, enables developers to write performance-portable algorithms, enables offline compilation of kernels, and it's a complete single-source C++ programming model. And ComputeCpp is then a flexible implementation of SYCL based on standard technologies, C++11, LLVM, Clang. It's fully customizable and supports multiple platforms. So, that's it. Thank you.
It's okay.
Are there... thanks. Are there any questions? Yes.
Do you have any test? Okay. So about you're submitting tasks to different queues. So you showed an example in which you can submit tasks to different queues, to the CPU and to the GPU, or actually I thought you're calling it DSP and CPU. Yeah, there we go, this one.
Yes.
So can you do this dynamically? I mean, can you do something like a runtime system in which you can actually split this sort of and on the fly decide which task goes to which?
Yes.
Device?
Yes, definitely. You can query the device for different information, and you can decide based on that, for example, on which queue you want to send your tasks to.
And have you done any experiments with this? Do you know whether it works and there is a good performance? Or
yes, I mean we have different tests to test the performance, and I don't know if parallel still does some of that.
Yeah, kind of.
There is already some use of this.
Okay, I'll be curious in more details about this. Thanks.
Okay.